Hi, and welcome to session 8 of our Coolselector deep dive. My name is Morten, and today we'll talk about valve opening curves. Now, in the previous sessions, we have discussed valves in almost all flow conditions. We've discussed incompressible, compressible flow, and we even touched upon choking. Today, we'll talk about the valve opening curves, that is, how the valve flow coefficient is actually affected on the valve opening. But let's start by just writing the basic valve equation. So, as we discussed last time, this equation covers both incompressible and compressible flow. Only difference is how you calculate the net expansion factor. But we haven't talked much about the KV value, the flow coefficient. We'll do that today because this value depends on the valve opening. And in Coolselector, we have more or less four different valve types that opens differently. If we start with the most simple valve types, that is the direct operated solenoids. When you open the valve, you reach the fully open KV value immediately. The valve KV is not a function of the pressure drop across the valve, it's only a function whether you have actually opened it or not. The second valve type is also a solenoid valve. It's the diaphragm solenoid valves. These valves are very much like the direct operated solenoid valves, except they have a diaphragm inside the valve. And for this diaphragm to actually open, you need a small pressure drop. So, instead of starting at zero, it starts at a certain opening pressure, and then it reaches the fully open KV value. The third valve type, that is the direct operated control valves or the manual control valves. These valves, you actually have the possibility to control the valve cone position. You can adjust it whether it should be 50% open or 100% open or 25% open for that matter. You have a direct possibility to control the valve opening. So instead of pressure drop across the valve, we will here write the valve travel H. So that is how much the valve is open. The opening characteristic of this valve looks more or less like this. We define a minimum opening below which we don't recommend the valve to be operated. And this is because if you go below the minimum opening, there is a chance of valve fluttering. Then there's the maximum opening, or the 100% opening, where you get the fully open KV value. So the characteristic more or less looks like this. The final valve type we look on, that is the solenoid, the servo piston operated solenoids or control valve. These valves, they actually require a certain pressure drop to open at all, and they require sometimes quite a bit of pressure drop to open fully. The characteristic of these valves look very much like the characteristic of the direct operated valves. Again, we have a minimum pressure drop below which we do not recommend to operate the valve. If you go below this, you have a chance of valve fluttering. We have a maximum pressure drop at which the valve is fully open. So here we have the fully open KV value. But using Coolselector, you do not necessarily need to care much about this. Coolselector will take care of all of this. It will calculate the opening curves depending on the valve type you select. The only thing you need to know is that Coolselector will report whether you are below the minimum opening pressure drop or below the minimum opening here, whether you are inside the partially open area like here, And this is because sometimes when you have a solenoid, it's actually nice to know that this solenoid is not fully open because the pressure drop across the valve is simply not big enough. But Coolselector will take care of it, and it will inform you where you are in any given situation. So this completes our talk about valves in incompressible, compressible, and for the opening curves. Next session, we'll turn to two-phase flow, and we'll talk about two-phase flow in pipes. Until then, you can download Coolselector on the Danfoss homepage, and thank you for watching.